What's up? It's AppleCritics from applecritics.com. In this video, I'm going to be showing you the latest and greatest software for the iPhone 5S and iPhone 6. And this particular software is iOS 12.4.7. So yes, Apple just released iOS 12.4.7. I've been using it for a day. So in this video, I'm going to be giving you my full-on review of it and what you should expect when you update it. So you're probably wondering why Apple is updating the older devices. Well, because Apple still wants to support the older devices and let them know that they are making sure that they're as secure as they can be. So this update actually comes 2 months after the initial release of iOS 12.4.6, which came out in late March. If you want to watch that video I did, I will have it as a card right up there. So I reviewed iOS 12.4.6 back in late March. So in this video, I'm going to be showing you what's new and how to install it and everything about iOS 12.4.7. So in this video, I'm using my iPhone 6 Plus. So that is what I'm using this iOS 12.4.7 on. So what we can do is go into settings, and then we can see that we have iOS 12.4.7 right here. This is exactly what it says. So iOS 12.4.7, 49.6 megabytes, and I'm coming from iOS 12.4.6. It says the iOS 12.4.7 provides important security updates and is recommended for all users, and some features may not be available for all regions or on all Apple devices. For information on the security content of the Apple software updates, please visit this website. So it has right there. So what we can do is just go ahead and hit that download and install button. And while we do that, what we can do is just go to general and then about. And then you can see it shows the software version, the model name, and the model number. And you can see that I'm currently running iOS 12.4.6 on my iPhone 6 Plus. So now you can see it is preparing the update, and it should go by really quick. So now you can see that it's currently preparing the update, and it shouldn't take too long. So now while it's preparing the update, what we can do is actually go to the support.apple.com link. And now we can learn more about the Apple security update. So it just tells you more about why Apple still does updates on the older devices, so such as the iPhone 5S and iPhone 6 and iPhone 6 Plus. So just for the just overall protection of the device. And if we scroll down, it just tells you more about the software updates. So it's telling you about the latest version of iOS and iPadOS, which is 13.5, and then for macOS and tvOS and watchOS. But then it has this very interesting chart that shows you everything about the latest update. So you can see that we have the update for iOS 13.5, and then it shows you what devices it's available for or just compatible with, when the release date was. So you can see you have iOS 12.4.7. It shows you all the devices that iOS 12.4.7 is compatible with. So just to name them, the iPhone 5S, the iPhone 6, the iPhone 6 Plus, the iPad Air, the iPad Mini 2, the iPad Mini 3, and then the iPod Touch 6th generation. And then it also tells you when the release date was. So you have the release date of May 20th, 2020. And then in brackets, it has the details available soon. And that's why the update was made. So if we look at the previous one, so we can just scroll all the way down to where it says iOS 12.4.6. You can see that it says this update has no published CVE entry. So the CVE was the exploit in the overall software and just the reason for the update. So it goes in depth. And once again, for iOS 12.4.5, which came out in January 28th, 2020, has all those available devices, but it just shows that there was no published CVE entry. So it's just showing that the software is now secure in simpler terms. So now you can see that it's verifying the update. And this part should be rather quick. And it's actually installing the software now. And now you can see that my iPhone 6 Plus is rebooting. So now you can see that the iPhone 6 Plus is booting up with iOS 12.4.7 right now. So now if we take a look, it says that your iPhone has been updated to iOS 12.4.7 and we are on the lock screen. And now we can go ahead and take a look at what iOS 12.4.7 has to offer. So now what we can do is go into settings and then general and then about. And now I can see that we're on iOS 12.4.7, and the build number for iOS 12.4.7 is 16G192. The modem firmware is 7.80.04. And you're probably wondering what's the significance of that. Well, that modem firmware remains unchanged since iOS 12.4.5, and what that means is no improvement on the cell connectivity or anything related to the cellular network and the modem. So basically nothing is changed. So now you're probably wondering what has changed in iOS 12. So firstly, you shouldn't expect too much in terms of new features. You shouldn't expect a new UI. You shouldn't expect some groundbreaking features. It's more of stability improvement. So the main purpose of this iOS 12.4.7 is to patch a vulnerability and fix performance, battery life, and cell connectivity. So that is the main features that Apple wants to improve, and just some overall bug fixes and just security enhancements overall. Now, one of the issues that's fixed is a text character bug. So that's fixed, and that's super small, but it's something that you wouldn't expect, but it's good that Apple fixed it. Now, Apple is just more focused on iOS 13 and iOS 14. Now, iOS 14 is actually right around the corner. It's only a month away, and then we'll be able to get our hands on the iOS 14 beta 1 at WWDC that Apple will have online. So I'm super excited for that, but Apple is just heavily focused on iOS 13 and iOS 14. As a majority of the newer devices that everybody has, and even some of the older devices, they have access to iOS 13. So that is why you don't really see any updates on iOS 12. Now, Apple doesn't really want to update the older devices, as it is a ploy to get you to upgrade. As the battery health also declines, that's another reason for people to upgrade their iPhone. And the battery health does not get better the more times you charge your device. And that's just a factor with lithium ion batteries. They just get worse as the years go by. Now, I still must say it's a good sign to see security updates for iOS 12 a few years later, because that's just good that Apple is just still taking care of the older devices and they still have some customer support overall. Now, the iPhone 5S and the iPhone 6 had a bunch of vulnerabilities previously, but all of them are pretty much patched and there's no more CVE entries and exploits for iOS 12.4.7 that was present on iOS 12.4.6. So as I showed earlier in the video, Apple didn't post the security exploits on their page. They still haven't updated it yet, and it's been a day, but eventually within the week, I still assume that they will. But the main vulnerabilities have been patched. Now, if you're wondering, the Check Rain JB does work on iOS 12.4.7, so that's another reason to upgrade. But yes, the JB will affect your device performance ever so slightly, so it can potentially slow down your device depending on what you have installed. If you have a bunch of certain JB apps and themes, then you're probably gonna notice a significant slowdown in performance and speed, and possibly a battery drain depending on how RAM intensive certain apps are. Now, the overall performance of iOS 12.4.7 does feel a lot like iOS 12.4.6. It's relatively smooth, and you can see that there's not really any lag at all, so you can see that the performance is really good. The RAM management when you go in an app and out of an app is still pretty snappy, so that's definitely what I like to see. And let's say we go in the App Store, and we can multitask and can see how fast it will go into the app and then out of the app. So there's no full reload or relaunch needed or having to swipe out of an app. It still works. So that's what I expect in the iOS 12.4.7 and any device that can run it, such as the ones I listed early in this video, such as the iPhone 6, iPhone 6 Plus, iPhone 5S as well. Now, don't expect to play any RAM-intensive devices like Fortnite or PUBG or COD Mobile on the iOS 12.4.7 on the iPhone 6 Plus or just any device that can run iOS 12.4.7. It just is not ready for prime time in terms of those heavy RAM-intensive games. That would not be good for the battery, that would not be good for the RAM, and it's not good for the overall device. I would recommend some smaller games, maybe like Subway Surfers, something that's really light on the device, doesn't have a lot of high quality graphics, and isn't just putting stress on the overall hardware of any iPhone or iDevice running on iOS 12.4.7. Those particular heavy RAM intensive games and games that take up a lot of storage space, just in general, those are just made for the newer devices and are optimized for iOS 13 and the latest software updates. Now, in terms of the battery life, well, you're probably wondering if the battery life did get any better. Well, that question is pretty much, it's the same. It's the same as iOS 12.4.6. These devices that are older devices pretty much have bad batteries. The batteries have gone through so many cycles, and once again, they are lithium ion, so that means that they're gonna get worse every time you charge them, and you shouldn't expect to charge a device to 100%. So if we take a look at the battery health on this particular iPhone 6 Plus on iOS 12.4.7, we can take a look at the battery health, and you're going to see that it says service. So that means that the battery health is not that good. And the maximum capacity that I can get out of this iPhone 6 Plus is 79% of battery life. So this is just a measure of the battery capacity relative to when it was new. So the lower capacity means that it may result in fewer hours of usage between charges. So that is as much as you can get. So 79% is a new 100% on this particular iPhone 6 Plus. Now, this is about 6 years old in September, so you can realize that that is still pretty good because it is a six-year-old device and it is on iOS 12.4.7. So you're probably wondering, should you update? Well, I would say you should, because there's no reason not to. You can still use CheckRain, the JB, and you get better security enhancements and just makes your device more secure. Not only that, it improves the performance ever so slightly, so that is why I would recommend it. Now, you're probably wondering why iOS 12 still has bugs. Well, the reason that it still has bugs is that people are very familiar with this hardware, number one, and the more times they're familiar with the hardware, they'll always discover some new bugs in iOS 12. So that is the reason why that Apple is still releasing certain updates. The longer that people have their hands on these devices, the more bugs that they're likely to find. So that was iOS 12.4.7 in a nutshell. Thank you so much for watching this video. Be sure to comment down below on what you think of iOS 12.4.7. Be sure to like this video, as I will make many more on iOS 12 and the older devices. Please be sure to subscribe for more great content and follow me on all the social media platforms. My username is applecritics, and I'm on Instagram, Twitter, and Facebook. And thanks for watching.